Hi, it's Tom here with Flightline Media. Let's build two American Eagles. We will choose Don Gentile's Spitfire as well as Claude Weaver's blue one. Gentile was one of the most famous P-51 aces, but did you know he began in a Spitfire? And Weaver was a Spitfire ace at only 18. Just take a look at these surface details. Amazing! We will start with the cockpit. I separated all of the parts for the cockpit area and started assembling. The cockpit parts are already outstanding, but Eduard improved that even more with PE parts, which are included in the box. After basic assembly, all cockpit components are painted with a black primer. And this is followed by RAF interior green. With black primer as a base, we can achieve good color tinting and avoid a uniform look. Then I use the PE parts again for the instrument panel. And also we need to clean parts before we glue them into place. For gluing PE parts I use CA glue, but you can also use white glue or even clear gloss, and in that case you'll have more time to align the parts. So it's time to start with the fuselage. I started by painting small components. Adding more PE parts. And in the end, spraying a clear gloss layer. This will be a layer for the next stage, wash and wettering. I start with the wash. As you can see, the wash is very diluted. And I simply brush it around all details in cockpit area. After a few minutes, while the wash is not completely dry, I start removing excess with the cotton swab. Then I applied a little dot of oil color and start blending them. If needed, you can use oil thinner to remove any unwanted excess. After that, I started with dry brushing. Using this method, you can highlight all the raised details and get the 3D feeling. At the end, I protect everything with final flat clear. And now it's time to assemble all of the cockpit parts. After the glue has dried, some joints need more attention, so I added some putty where needed. And while the putty dries, I glued some parts on the fuselage. And now the clear parts. My way is glue them with the Tamiya extra thin with very small amount of glue. Then we need to protect clear parts from future works, and for that I use pre-cut mask supplied in the box. Like with the cockpit, I use black primer again all over. And there they are, two black beauties. Painting starts with the bottom of the model. First, I started with irregular strikes over the black primer. Then I sprayed all over with very diluted paint. At the end, we will have nice paint coverage, but not so uniform. And this will be good base for future weathering. When I have a chance, I love freehand paintings, like here on wheelbase. After the paint dries, we need to mask the bottom with the masking tape. I sprayed dark green camo color, freehand with 0.15 needle and very low pressure. And here is the second one with very interesting painting scheme. We start with middle stone color the same way like we do on the first model. And camo color is dark earth applied freehand again. Now it's time to dress up with your Spitfire. We need very diluted blue color. To match the blue tone, I mixed a little gray. Then we applied very thin layers over the camouflage, so at the end the original camo will be barely visible under the blue overspray. Starting with Weaver Spitfire, I cut decals from the sheet, place them into warm water for a few seconds and place them on the model. All excess water is cleaned up with contrast swab. And now the fun part. Eduard has new type of decals where you can remove carrier film and make the markings look like they are painted. You should be very careful to not destroy it. And for this method I use sharp knife blade and tweezers. And water can remove any excess of decal glue. Now it's time to protect all decal works with another layer of clear gloss. I let it dry for 24 hours and start applying wash. After some 10 minutes, I clean up all excess with cotton swab and paper towel. I made some chipping in some places. I used a piece of sponge moistened with silver color. Then I remove almost all color from the sponge and now we can make some chipping. the moment of truth, unmasking clear parts and adding some small details. Radio wires are made from stretch material and glued in place with a drop of CI glue. I hope you liked our first video. Stay tuned for more upcoming interesting and never before seen projects. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Bye!